Hi students, a very pleasant and warm greetings to you all. Hope you are doing good. Last session we have seen about looping structure in PHP, right? And today we are going to see about forms and files. Before learning about forms and files, let's see a recap of yesterday's portion. Yesterday we have seen about looping structure. In the looping structure in PHP, we have for loop, for each loop, while loop and do while loop. I hope that you are clear with the conditional statements and looping structure, right? And we'll start about the forms and structure. Okay, forms and structure means in HTML we are going to create form. Okay, last year in grade 11 itself we have created form. We'll just have a recap here how we can create a form in HTML, and we'll see the PHP codes also to create the form and file. Okay, here the main goal or the main objective of this PHP or this HTML to create form is to collect the data from the user. Okay, the user will be there and the user can give the data through a form, and we can collect the data from users through this form, right? So this will be helpful for the machine or the computer. Collect the details from clients. Okay, here the client will be having a web page, or the client have to go inside a website and they'll give the details in a form like structure. Okay, and the machine or the computer or the system will get access to the details through the forms. Okay, here in this HTML we'll have text box, drop down box, radio button. We have seen last year itself, right? First let's see the basic form controls, which is in HTML. Okay, here we have text input, buttons, checkbox, radio button, file select, form tag. Okay, this we have seen last year itself. We are just having a recap of it. Okay, you have learned in grade 11 itself. If you don't remember, just take your grade 11 book and just read it once. Okay, and then read this forms and files lesson, so it will be easy. Here they have given the whole form creation of HTML in just a single paragraph. You had a separate lesson for creating form in HTML, right? You have done the practical also in creating a form or the registration form or login forms, right? And here they have given text inputs, button, checkbox, radio box, file select and form tag, right? Text box means we all know it will have a text box where we can enter the text, or it will have a text area, right? And buttons means submit button will be there, cancel button will be there, confirm button will be there, reset button will be there. In the last, after filling all the forms, all the details in the forms, last you will have a button, right? Maybe reset or submit or cancel. Likewise, some buttons will be there. That is buttons. Okay, next one is checkbox. Checkbox means this is a main feature here. In this feature we can select more than one values. Checkbox means we all know, right? Some options will be there, some like choose the correct answer, some options will be there. Checkbox means we can select more than one. You can select two or three or maybe four options also you can select, right? Radio box means this is similar to the checkbox only, but here you can select only one value. Okay, checkbox means you can select more than one value. You can select two values or three values. But radio button means only one value you can select. If you select the other one, the first selected will be cancelled, or it will be unchecked, and which you are selecting at the last only will be, only one option will be valid, or only one option can be entered there. And next one is file select. File select means we can select one file from our computer or from your device, and you can upload it. For that we have this file select option, right? And then next one, form tag. Form tag means we all know we use post or get tag, right? This is used to create a form. Okay, this entire control of this HTML document or this HTML form will be mentioned by this method. Okay, this method is what, post or get method will give, right? And we'll see the PHP basic form handling. Okay, here we will see how we will create a form in HTML, and we'll see the PHP basic form handling also. Okay, when the user is giving an input in this HTML, we'll have a submit button, right? But when you click the submit button, their request will be generated and it will reach the PHP file, right? This we will mention it under the form tag. Okay, in this form tag we have two methods, post method and get method, right? This method is a attribute of this form tag. Okay, once this this details is reaching, when this data is reaching the server, two PHP variables will be will collect the data from the client side, right? That two variables are post and get. Okay, here we will use this as dollar symbol and then underscore post. Okay, dollar underscore post. The same way for get also, dollar symbol then underscore then get, get will give in capital letters. Okay, this post and get only collects the data and it will prepare as if the client needs, right? First let's see what is post method. Okay, this post method means this input data will be sent to the server with this post method, right? Here this will be stored in the request body of the client's request. Okay, client's request will say it as client's HTTP request, right? In this client's request body, this post method will save the input data which is sent to the server. Okay, get method means this input data sent to the server with post method will be given with the URL address, right? URL address means we all know link, which will be written in blue color with a underlined manner, right? This is a query string, right? This URL address is known as the query string, and all the input which are visible by the user after clicking this submit button will be in this query string, right? And let's see a example for this now. Test.html, right? Whatever we are saving in HTML, we have saved as name.html, right? We'll give the file name and then .html. That's what they have given here. First the file name, right? They have saved as test and .html. If you are saving it in PHP, we'll save it as test.php, right? First, here HTML, we have a HTML opening tag. We all know that. Whenever you are writing a HTML tag, we'll open with HTML tag. Tag and inside that we'll write HTML. How will you end that? Slash HTML, right? Inside that body tag. Body tag has been opened, and at last before closing the HTML tag, the body tag is closed, right? Inside that we are going to create a form. We know this already. We have created form in grade 11 itself, right? Here also the same thing is given. Form action, and we have to create the PHP document there, and we'll insert the name of the PHP file here. Okay, here we have given welcome.php. That means in this welcome file, which is saved in this PHP format, will be included here, right? Form action welcome.php. This is given inside double quotes. Okay, next method is equal to post. This post or get, that one also will be given inside this double quotes, right? And then next one, name, we need a text box, right? For that we will give input type is equal to text, right? Name is name, will be displayed there, so that is given inside double quotes, right? Are you clear? Name, input type is equal to text. Text and name will be inside double quotes, and this input type, this whole thing will be inside a tag, right? And we need a break. We need to get the next details in the next line. So we are using BR. BR means break. That line will be break, and then the next thing will be displayed in the new line, right? Next we need a email. So email also we can use this text box itself. So we are giving it into input type text, name is equal to email, and next line, for next line we are giving next break. And in a new line, next we need a submit button, right? input type is equal to submit. We are giving and we are closing the form tag, and as you saw already, body tag and HTML tag is closed, right? Next, we are going to give the PHP file, right? In this PHP file, how will you give? PHP file also, we are starting it with HTML tag and body tag. Inside that, welcome. We know the PHP tag, how will you open? The tag first and then question mark, and then we'll give PHP, right? And whatever you need to display, you will give it in echo, right? In this echo, you are giving dollar underscore post, right? Inside this, you are giving the name inside double quotes, inside the bracket, name double quotes, right? In this PHP, the line will end up with semicolon only. You have to end the line. The line, all the lines will end in semicolon, right? So here also it's ending with semicolon. And how will you close the PHP tag? Question mark and this greater than symbol, right? In this tag we have closed, and we are giving a break also. BR is break, right? And next one is your email address is. Inside this email address, this that form has to be processed in this PHP, and it has to give the output, right? For getting the output only, we are giving this PHP codes. So here again, next PHP code, we are opening the PHP tag, echo dollar underscore post, and we are calling this email, right? Email inside double quotes and inside the bracket, and we are ending it with semicolon, and we'll end this PHP tag with question mark, and the tag will be closed. And at last, slash body and slash HTML. We are closing the body tag and HTML tag, right? If you give this code, we'll get the output in this format, right? Name and one text box will be there. Email and then text box will be there. And then submit button will be there. And in the output side, we are given in this PHP, right? So, welcome. And then whatever you are giving inside the first name box will be displayed here near the welcome. And your email address is... And whatever you are giving here in this email address text box will be displayed here. Right? Understood? Here you have two text box, name text box and email text box. And one button is there. Button for submit. Right? Submit button and one form tag. Right? This welcome.php. This is the remote server PHP file. Right? This only does the process inside and gets the output correctly here, right? Here in this welcome.php file, some PHP variables like post, get, this will collect the data and it will prepare the response accordingly, right? However, we are giving in that manner, we'll get the output, right? This in the same time, this user will receive the output response in the client machine in the browser screen itself. Okay, when if you are a client and you are logging in here, you will get a name and then text box, right? In our display, in our screen, in our browser screen itself, we'll get the output, or we'll get whatever we are giving in the box will be displayed in the output section also, right? Welcome and whatever name we are giving will be displayed here. And your email address is, whatever mail ID you are giving in the email text box, that will be given, that will be shown in the our screen itself, right? Next one is basic PHP form validation, right? The word valuation means, we all know, if correcting the paper, we'll say it is a valuation, right? Likewise, validation means checking. So here the validation process means checking the input data which is submitted by the client or the user, right? Here we have two types of validation, client side validation and server side validation, right? Here the input input values are given, and the client side validation will be performed in client's machine. Server side validation will be performed in server side machine, right? So here in client machine, the client valuation will be taken place using JavaScript, right? Like the scripts, like JavaScript, and some adding, it will add the required attributes in the HTML input tags, right? In server side, this process will be performed by using PHP or ASP or JSP or whatever is available in the server machine, right? this HTML form will take the input from the site visitor and then it will post it back to the end application, right? What are the end applications? You know, we know this PHP script, ASP, CGI script, these are all this end application, right? And this backend end application means this is the backend application, right? This will perform the what are the process needed to process the data based on the business or based on the client's requirement. This application will be performed, right? Okay, next, this for this validation we have some rules for HTML input field, right? We have seen text input for name. Name means we'll have letters and white space. Only letters and white space will be there. Email address means it will have a @, right? Whatever email ID we know, Jenny Mansi at gmail.com or at yahoo.com will be there, right? So email text input means it will have @ symbol. Website means it will have a URL, right? Radio button means, or radio box means, it will have minimum one selectable value, right? Checkbox means also will have minimum one selectable value or checkable value, right? Drop down menu also, it must have at least one value, right? Next, in this client side validation, before the data is sent, the server side program, their programmer will be there, right? That programmer will write some validation from the browser in this client machine, right? For this validation only, we have to add some attributes, or we can add some whatever attributes of the codes are needed, we can add in this in HTML input tag, right? We can see this example here, input required attribute in this HTML you have to give. Form action is equal to welcome, like this you will open and then you will give username. Input type is equal to text, name is name, and you will give here will give us required. Okay, required means you are adding this. This is required means this must be filled. Okay, if you are not filling and if you are giving submit means it will show us please fill this text, or it will show us this is compulsory, you must fill this text and then only you can submit. So if this is a compulsory one, it will give we can give this as a required attribute. This required input attribute, if you are giving, it will notify you that you can fill this column and then only you can move to the next one, right? You are clear about this forms. Next, you are going to see about file. Okay, this file handling will be a important thing in all the web application development process, right? Here this is processed for various tasks. We'll see some of this here. PHP open a file, PHP read a file, PHP close a file, PHP write a file, PHP appending a file, PHP uploading a file. First, let's see what is PHP open a file. F open, this is the code for opening a file, right? F open off, this means this function only helps to open a file. Okay, here we will have two parameters, one for the file and the next one is here we have to specify which mode you have to open the file, either read or write. Okay, let's see the syntax first. Here $file_object is equal to, you have to give the code for opening the file, F open. Inside the bracket you will have two parameters, as I said. First one is, first you have to give the file name. Next one, read or write mode, that you have to mention there, right? First is file name, that you have to give inside double quotes, comma, and then read or write mode. Okay, and see an example here. First you have to open the PHP tag and then you have to give the file object, $myfile is equal to, then the code, F open. Okay, then here they have given the file name as student.txt. Okay, file name as student.txt, and then you have to give comma R means read mode, right? This read mode, or die. If there is some error you have to give this error message, right? That error message also you can give here. You have to give die inside the bracket. You are giving unable to open a file, or you can give error, whatever you need. The error message you have to give in the second part, right? And we'll end this with semicolon. Okay, the next one is PHP read a file. Read a file means we'll read the file which is opened, right? This file object comes from this f open functions only. Okay, see the syntax, f read in the bracket dollar file object, then file size in the bracket, you have to give file name inside the double quotes, and you have to close the whole bracket and then semicolon, right? If you are taking an example also, you will write inside the PHP tag f read, then inside the bracket dollar my file comma file size, inside the bracket you will write the name student dot text inside double quotes, and you will close the both the brackets and end with semicolon, and then at last ending with the closing PHP closing tag, right? Then PHP close a file. For closing a file, we have the function is f close function, right? You will use f close function. This is used to close a file which is opened. Okay, this file object also comes from this f open function only. Okay, here the syntax is f close, in the bracket you will give the dollar file object. Okay, here if you see the example, they'll give dollar my file is equal to f open, inside the bracket you are giving what file object you gave there, file object in this f open. F open what we gave? File object, right? File object is equal to F open, and then the file name, and then its mode, write mode or read mode, right? Here inside this F open, also here you are giving the file name for student dot text, and then read. Whatever you need, you are giving R, and then whatever codes have to be executed, that codes you will give down, and then here we are opening a file, and then you will write the code, and where you have to close it, there in that place you will give f close, inside that f close tag you will give the my file, right? Dollar my file. Oh, what is that? That is the file object, right? That my file you will give, and you will close it and end with the semicolon. And then the closing tag for PHP is question mark greater than symbol, right? And the last one is PHP write a file. Okay, this f write function is used to write to a file, right? And the syntax for this is f write inside the bracket my file and text will be there, right? Dollar my file comma dollar text, and this line also will end with semicolon, right? Are you clear about this forms and files? In the forms we saw, we have the HTML form controls, right? The basic form controls are text inputs, buttons, checkbox, radio box, file select and form tag, right? And then we saw the post and get, the methods for handling this basic PHP form. And then we saw the validation. In this validation, we saw client side validation and server side validation. And next one, file, we saw how to open a file, read a file, write a file, appending or uploading a file, and then at last we saw about closing a file, right? That's all in this lesson. You just read this lesson, just it's a very small lesson. You just read it today itself, and make sure you learn the portions whichever I ask you to study on that day itself, right? In the group I am updating it daily. Please make sure learn the particular chapter which I say to learn on that day itself. And if you find any questions difficult, or if you find any doubts in that questions, you can call me or you can text in that group also. I'll be happy to clear your doubts, or if you want me to explain any other topics again also, you can say me. I'll just explain it again. Okay, so make sure you learn the portions on that day itself, so that it will be easy for your final exams, right? Thank you for your valuable time. Stay home, stay safe, take care, bye.